There are treasures so important we keep them safely locked away. A wisp of baby hair, some photos, and tucked into boxes in homes everywhere are letters and postcards signed by Mr. Rogers. This year brought the unveiling of a postage stamp bearing the likeness of the television neighbor. The honor is especially right because Fred Rogers was known to always write back.
Let's send a note to Mr. Rogers, because, you know, kids love to get mail.
Jill Neely's daughter, Ruthie, was two and watched Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood every day.
One day, he did an episode about brushing your teeth. Later that evening, when Ruthie was getting ready for bed, she was standing at the sink brushing her teeth, and she said, "Look, Mommy, I'm just like Mr. Rogers." We sent those and wrote a letter to Mr. Rogers, and I forgot all about it.
Sure enough, he wrote back.
So he says, "Dear Ruth, thank you so much for sending me the wonderful picture of you taking good care of your teeth. I'm proud of the way you're growing inside and out." Can't you just hear him saying that? I can hear him saying these words. This is the photo he mentioned, and you can see how well loved it is. She carried that with her. She loved it. The man you saw on TV truly was as good as he conveyed himself to be. He had a good heart, and he really did care about his television friends.
He answered every letter. His signature was on every letter.
David Newell worked on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood as Mr. McFeely, the delivery man.
I have a surprise speedy delivery.
We would get, I would say, a couple hundred pieces of mail a day in the height of the program.
Every piece of viewer mail is stored in the archives of the Fred Rogers Center in Latrobe, cataloged by topic and date. Fred insisted on it since his earliest days on TV, when volunteers accidentally threw away some bags of mail.
And Fred said, "What? You can't do that. You can't do that." Every letter had to be answered. That he thought that the mail was the most important thing representing the program.
In 1996, Family Communications Company published a book of letters.
"Dear Mr. Rogers, did you get in trouble when you were little?" And his answer is, "Dear neighbor, I think everyone sometimes does things that are upsetting to other people. When I was a boy, I didn't like it when I did something. My daddy works at Sears. Do you have a job too?" And he wrote, "Dear Stephen, it was good to know about your father's work. My job is making our television."
David Newell has kept his own letters from Fred.
We were on the set of Dr. Quinn, Medicine Woman, at the Paramount Ranch in California. The only time he's ever played a part other than Mr. Rogers. It says, "Dear David, here we are in Colorado Springs in the 19th century," and with two exclamation points. And I treasure this, I really do.
Do you miss him?
Oh yes, I miss his sense of humor, and I miss these.
Throughout his career, Mr. Rogers received and answered many thousands of letters from children and their parents. Each letter carries a memory of a mailman delivering a bit of the Mr. Rogers kindness. Ruthie Neely is now a busy adult with a beautiful smile. She had waited 5 months for her letter to arrive.
"I'm sorry you had to wait so long to hear from us. We've been very busy making our television visits." The fact that somebody who is Mr. Rogers would even apologize to a little two-year-old for not getting back to her sooner. And again, that shows the respect that he had for people.
Doesn't that sound just like the Mr. Rogers we knew from television?
"You always make each day such a special day. You know how.
By just your being you, your television friend, Mr. Rogers." That's sweet.